Today we are going to discuss on the another mode of reproduction. Yes, students, the sexual reproduction. This type of reproduction is found in the higher categories of organism. And students, sexual reproduction may be defined as the kind of reproduction in which the fusion of male and female gametes fuse to form zygote. The formation of zygote is take place by a process that is called fertilization, and after fertilization the zygote further goes on the developmental process, and with the complexion of the developmental process the embryo is formed. This embryo, after the a developmental period, give rise to the birth of an individual. Thus students, first of all we are going to discuss about the sexual reproduction. Students, as I told you that in this process the fusion of gamete cells take place. This is the male gamete cell, and this is the female gamete cell. Students, male gamete, this is also called sperm, and this is ova or egg. The fusion of these gametes fuse to form zygote, and this process is known as fertilization. What is, students? Fertilization. It means the fusion of male and female gamete is known as fertilization. The zygote contain the haploid and haploid number of chromosomes to become diploid, and after the developmental process the zygote further develops into embryo, and embryo after the gestation period it give rise to the birth of an individual. Thus students, it is clear that for the process of sexual reproduction there is the two parent is required, or there is the presence of two types of gametes that are formed from the particular type of reproductive organs. If we are talking about the unisexual organism, then the male gametes are formed inside the body of the male parent, and the female gametes are formed inside the body of female gamete. Students, some of the organisms are also such a way that if you are talking about the earthworm is a hermaphrodite organism, because in earthworm the male reproductive organ and the female reproductive organ both are present in a single organism. That's why the earthworm is also known as bisexual organism. Now students, first of all we are going to study about the sexual reproduction in plants. Yes students, the sexual reproduction in plants. Thank you. production in plants. Students, the reproductive part of a flowering plant is flower. Yes, students, the flower is the reproductive part of a plant, and a flower bears, a typical flower bears 4 important roles. Yes, students, a typical flower bears 4 important roles. Before going to know about the sexual reproduction in plants, it is immensely important to understand what are the different roles found in a flower. Then, students, here I am going to draw the different part of a flower. This is the innermost part of a typical flower, that is also called pistil or carpel or gynoecium. This is the ovary, inside which the more number of ovules are present. And these are the male reproductive part of the flower, that is called stamen. Stamen, this is the third row, and from the central part, this is the second row. After that, this is the third role of a typical flower, that is the colorful role of the flower and called the petals or corolla. And this is the green outermost role of a flower, that is called calyx or sepal. This is the pedicel at which the flower is located. This is the thalamus part at which the various roles of the flower are located. This is the calyx. This is the green roll of the flower and also called sepals. This is the corolla and also called petals. It is non-green or black or brightly colored roll of the flower. In the different species, the different color of the petals are present, and this is the ovary, this is the ovules, these are the ovules that lies inside the ovarian wall. This is the style. This is the stigma. The stigma style, ovary and ovules, these captively form the pistil. And you can also call it carpel. Pistil or carpel are collectively called gynoecium. This is the female reproductive part of a flower. Now, students, this is the anther, the filament filament, and the ether and filament are linked together by a connective tissue. What? A connective tissue. And students, the ether and filaments collectively called stamen. Stamen are endosperm. This is the male reproductive part of flower. Thus, students, there are four roles are present in a typical flower. What are these? The first and outermost role is calyx or sepal. The second role is corolla or petals. The third role is androecium or stamen, and the fourth role is the gynoecium or pistil or carpel. Thus, students, these are the four important roles of a typical flower, and this is the structure of a typical flower. And students, the flower is the reproductive part of the plant. Now students, we are going to more discuss about these roles of the flower. Calyx, this is the green outermost role of a flower, which lies just upon the thalamus part of the flower. The second role is the corolla or petals. It is brightly color or colorful role of the flower. In the different flower, different color of petals are present. Students, these petals helps in attracting the insects. That's all helpful in the performing the important process of pollination in plants. And this is the third role, androecium or stamen. It is the male reproductive role of the flower in different flower from few to uncountable number of stamens are present, which are collectively called androecium. And this is the innermost and the central, or you can say that fourth role of the flower, that is the gynoecium, also called pistila carpel. Students, the gynoecium has mainly three parts: the stigma, style, and ovary. We know more about the androecium and gynoecium in detail to understand the process of fertilization and the reproduction in plants. Dear students, first of all, here I am taking the androecium. It is consist of the large number of stamens are from few to more number of stamens. A stamen has mainly two parts, Here I draw a structure of a stamen. This is a type, thickest type of stamen or diocese stamen. This is the anther. This part of the stamen is known as anther, and the part through which this is the filament, and the part through which the filament joins with the anther or linked with the anther, that is called connective tissue. Connective tissue, because it helps in attaching the anther on the filaments. This is a stamen. And students, if we are transversely take the section of the anther, then what will we find? Here we find the anther has many chambers. It may be from 2 to 4 chambers. It depends upon the presence of number of chambers in different types of plant species, and inside which there is large number of small dust particles like spores are present. Students, these are called the pollen grains. What? Pollen grains. And the chambers are called pollen chamber. Pollen chamber. Its outer wall is somewhat thick and called endothecium. What, students? Endothecium. And the inner wall is very slippery and called tapetum. What, students? Tapetum. And inside the tapetum, large number of minute grains like structures are present that are called pollen grains. And pollen grains are the male gamete. These are the male gamete. If we are going to talking about a single structure of a pollen grain, then it looks like that. It is encloses inside the two wall. The outer wall is exine wall and the inner is intine wall. Inside the intine wall, there is nucleus substances are present along with the nucleus that containing haploid number of chromosomes. Haploid or N number of chromosomes are present in a pollen grain. A single pollen grain is illustrated here. And this is the reason through which the pollen tube is originated when the pollen grain is transferred from anther to the stigma of the flower during favorable conditions for fertilization. Now students, we are also going to discuss about the detailed structure of the gynoecium, female reproductive part of the flower. Students, some of the flowers contain only single carpels in their gynoecium, whereas few contains more than one carpel in a flower. On the basis of the number of gynoecium present in the flower, they are called the monocarpellary, bicarpellary or multicarpellary. Yes students, on this basis here I am taking a structure of monocarpellary type of gynoecium containing a single pistil or carpel. This is the topmost flat, somewhat flattened part of our carpel, that is called stigma. And this is the flask like structure, that is called the ovary, that lies just upon the thalamus part of the flower. And this flattened structure is stigma. This tube like structure is style. This is the ovary and inside the ovary large number of ovules are present, but here I am take a single ovule. How a ovule lies inside the ovary during the process of fertilization, I will illustrate here with the help of this diagram. This is the structure of a single ovule that lies inside the ovary. These are the synergized cells, among which the only one cell is going for the process of fertilization. This is the secondary nucleus and three antipodal basal cells are also present in a single nucleus. Beside it, the vacuoles are present, and this is the structure of an ovule. Yes, students, ovules after fertilization get developed into seed, whereas the ovary after fertilization starts swell up and after ripening it get converts into the fruits. This type of changes take place in a typical flower whose flowers bears fruits. Now students, this is the topmost flattened part of the female reproductive part of the flower. This is called stigma. The transfer of pollen grains from anther to the stigma of the flower take place. This process is known as pollination. And when the pollen grains reach at the stigma, a special type of nutritious substance and enzymes is secreted inside the style of the carpel that helps in the development of the pollen tubes in the pollen grains. This pollen tube increases laterally and reaches at the micropyle region of the disc ovule. And when it reached at the micropyle region, it secretes two male gamete cells. One is fused with the secondary nucleus, and another fuses with the synergized cell, or it is also called X cell. Thus, this type of fertilization is known as double fertilization. Thus, students, I hope you will understand the male and female reproductive part of the flower very well. We more discuss about the process of fertilization and the further process of the reproduction in plants in our next video lecture. Thanks, students, for joining today's lecture.